a bright start, isn't it? At every point, we're going to have a cacophony of noise.
Let one laugh.
Ooh.
Love to.
She'll take that off the net, Miwa Harimoto.
It brings shivers down your spine, doesn't it, when you hear the shrieks of the crowd after every point scored, knowing that this is a world final and this is Miwa Harimoto's first ever time playing a World Table Tennis Championships.
So impressive. So that is Sun Yingsha's first point.
I mean, there's something to be said for the younger sibling ending up being the one in the spotlight.
Yeah, he was a 50, he was her age when he was already creating headlines, wasn't he?
Let one, two.
Tomokazu Harimoto, who lost out in the quarterfinals to China.
Nice that. Winning that backhand serve with minor adjustments being made, minor changes in placement being brought about.
Now, Miwa Harimoto's record against Chinese players is actually impressive. 38%. Dismissive backhand from Sun Yingsha, but she is young. Some of those would be, not many of those would be the top, top players, but still, it's an encouraging sign for Miwa Harimoto.
Certainly is. She's already beaten Chen Chenyi and lost narrowly to Wang Yidi. So already faring very well against the top tier Chinese. Obviously never beaten Sun Yingsha. Chen Meng either, but I mean, relatively speaking, if you look at the upward curve of her improvement, it should happen at some point. What a time it would be if today was the day.
I just feel that she seems a lot less jittery today than she was yesterday. A lot less tentative. I know it's very early days. Well, who was that? Mima Ito. Not selected. It's been a little bit of a talking point. She, who has been for so long described as the bane of Team China. And it might be injury related, but didn't see her standing up very much yesterday.
Well, we heard rumours that it might be the case that Mima won't be playing singles. I mean, she improved so quickly, beating the likes of Chen Meng and Ding Ding at the time. But then, like basically every player, Team China works them out.
Yeah.
Maybe that's why they're going with Miu Hirano and Miwa, because they're, well, in Miwa's case, newer to the scene, and in Hirano's case, returning from the shadows, in a sense. So, and also, Miu Hirano, the last non-Chinese out-and-out attacker to beat Sun Yingsha.
Sun Yingsha now with the biggest lead she's enjoyed thus far, 3 points. Well, if there's anything we've learned, Fraser, in this event, is clearly the way to ruffle the Chinese feathers is to do something or play in an unusual way. Yeah. Not the usual.
You've got to be a bit weird, a bit wacky.
Yeah. Now, again, I harp back to the World Championship performance of Hina Hayata against Wang Yidi. Last year, where she played shallower, she played slower, and it worked a treat. Not saying we necessarily have to do that with Sun Yung Sha, but along those lines, we saw Aika Mukherjee do it as well. But that's a pip situation, isn't it?
That's right.
But it just indicates that you have to change it up.
You can have an out-and-out attacking style, but you've still got to try and disrupt the rhythm and be unpredictable. That's the name of the game right there. And a lot of players try and beat the Chinese by copying the thing that the Chinese invented. And is that sustainable? No, it's not. And we see that.
What would you necessarily maybe advocate here?
Well, Miwa is that kind of player who is an out-and-out attacking player. I just think she has to try to switch down the line as much as possible with the backhand. She's getting a service warning here, the 15-year-old. She has to move Sun around as much as possible.
It's coming at her very fast. Harimoto. Well, this is already better than it was the last time that they met, as I mentioned. It was a donut at the star contender, a bagel. She lost 11 love.
What I need.
Yeah, it was a very convincing win. 11 love, 11-3, 11-6 for Sun Yung Sha. That was after a fairly tight WTT finals in Nagoya.
The timing of that forehand from Sun wasn't a bad shot from Miwa, but the explosivity, the compactness, the efficiency, prolific.
Five game points already for Sun Yung Sha. Well, she's done it pretty comfortably, Sun Yung Sha. So let's see what Harimoto does here. It's a lot to put on a 15-year-old, isn't it, when you're playing the world number one, the world champion. And you've got to sort of set the standard for the rest of this tie. It's a big ask.
That's how good Miwa Harimoto is. She's an uncompromising young player.
That's a Harimoto way, isn't it?
Yeah, she's not going to lie down. You really have to beat her. And that's something that you can't teach. That's a personality trait right there. Adjusting her service position here, coming in with the shovel serve, it looks like. It's a decent one as well.
Yeah. She's been given that added responsibility, hasn't she? If this goes down to the wire, she plays a deciding match.
Kick a serve.
Good serve. I was just going to say, what do you like about that?
Pendulum one, look at this. Top edges off the racket. Sun there, didn't know where and how to meet it. That's encouraging when you can win 2 points without having to play a third ball.
2-3.
Have the lead here. Yeah, annoyed herself.
Went for the kill. Half long, gets the bat high, but Sun spinning into the middle.
Not the right shot selection for you on that one?
From
Miwa?
Yeah, yeah, I think she's going to go for the counter there. Yeah. She just didn't plant the feet quick enough. But it was a nice ball from Sunt. Give credit there to the winner.
How frustrating is it? You start so well, and then within a snap of a finger, it's all gone.
Well, it's not ideal, Shahzad.
Thank you, Fraser.
It's not ideal. But early doors here. Down the parallels from Miwa Haramoto. You've really got to be able to play that short side well.
Yeah. You're right.
It's a side that your opponent will be guarding less because they know themselves it's harder to play.
Yeah, which is why you could see Shining Char just transferring to the right-hand side there. Wrong-footed by Harimoto, who's back in front here. She dictated that one all the way, Harimoto.
A lesson in control. Look at those blocks. Sun was playing catch-up, but that one too far gone. See you later.
Fantastic from Harimoto. Well, you know Sun Yung-sha can produce stuff like that as well.
Wow. It's that irregular training, multi-ball, getting fired thousands of balls at you in different locations and having to basically just get it imprinted to the extent that it's instinct. Even if a ball's put into your middle, you can still play a winner off that.
Yeah. Well, so far we've seen Miwa Harimoto start pretty well in both these games, but then Sun Yung-sha just surges ahead. So she's got to just try and keep pace.
Or change it.
Yeah, that would be, I think, the really interesting move. Not easy to do.
She's trying to serve a little bit slower here. Miwa Haramoto to try and give herself more time for the third ball. Tries to create a bit of a juxtaposition by going for a big banger, but didn't have enough topspin on it, did it? Seemed like a bit of a snatchy shot.
This is where, like the last game, Sun Yung-sha starts to pull away.
Yeah, the alarm bells are ringing now. Deep push, and Miwa re-pushes there and gets spanked for it.
Look at that. Six of the last eight have gone Sun Yung-sha's way.
With the serves now as well, you become really concerned for Miwa Haramoto.
Yeah, good point. It was 3-1 to Miwa Haramoto earlier. It's all changed now. Well, that'll give her confidence that she can go into these rallies with Sun Yung-sha and come out on top from time to time, but she needs more of it.
There are no 15-year-olds in China that are this level. Sun knows that. Treat this with the utmost respect. And she is doing. Look at this serve here. Pendulum stamps the foot. Very common now to serve a long serve with backspin. If you serve it with topspin, it better have that surprise factor, or it's going to be easy for your opponent to come over it with power. But with a backspin, one, they have to move and then come up the back of the ball. A lot more body work required with a long backspin serve. Or against.
Moved her around beautifully. Harimoto. Again, going down the line pays dividends. She's learning, right? She's picking stuff up. She's definitely playing better than the first game. Miwa Harimoto.
Let 7-8.
She has a second chance to serve. What will she do?
Well, she tried the reverse, but now she's going in with the shovel, it seems. Yeah. Doesn't contact that as she wanted to there, Sun, but what they've both done very well this game is pushed aggressively. That one, not much backspin. Obviously didn't need it.
Play, please.
Umpire just trying to nudge things along.
A little bit wider with that serve, wasn't it? And then meanwhile tried to flip with power, but you can see there, not much space to work with.
Yeah, Sunil Shah happy about that one.
Didn't look like the best choice of receive there from Miwa Harimoto.
Now, two game points. Two game points, Sun Ying Sha. One serve now, Harimoto. She went for it, didn't she? In this third game.
You wonder how it could change from here, though.
Yeah, what's the evolution?
Yeah,
in 2024.
To 50 years in the in the future. Goodness knows, she's out. Like, you find it harder to believe it could get quicker.
Yeah, I'm not sure how.
One-all.
Could there be a 10-year-old kid playing in a World Championship final? You doubt it, don't you?
Yeah, right now, this 15-year-old's struggling in this final. Sun Ying Sha wins this game and trying to go one up here in this tie.
Cracking backhand from Sun. You don't think of her as a backhand player, but look at that. Exemplary performance here so far.
It's almost a sign there from on Hanimoto's face that it writing might just be on the wall for this first match. Still some way to go, but Sun Ying Sha, you feel like she's just revving things up here. With a nice 3-point lead. Really needs to do something pretty good from here, pretty special, Miwa Harimoto, to stay in this. Well, Fraser's been advocating doing something different because, quite frankly, what she has been doing just hasn't troubled Sun Ying Sha enough, has it?
No, we need to see some different serves. Sun is so used to these kind of rallies. It is virtually impossible to beat Sun Yingsha, trying to outpace her. So the key is to outplace her.
And by doing that, you're going to have to look at placement, maybe take the pace off just a tad, be a bit more accurate.
She was trying to do that with the serves, Miwa Hatamotsu. She was trying to do slower serves, but they weren't different serves in terms of the style of them, where she was serving from.
She went for riskier shots in the second game as well, didn't she?
Yeah.
That kind of helped for a bit. That kind of worked for a little while.
Yeah.
It's already a 4-point lead here in this third game for Sun Yingsha. Went for it there, Sun Yingsha.
The switch seems to be coming slightly too late for me. Got to do it very, very early. That's how her brother Tomokazu Hanamoto broke through, winning the Czech Open and then the Japan Open, beating Chinese for fun. You've got to switch them very soon. You've got to get them out of position as soon as you can.
So you're saying that play to the down the line should have been earlier?
Yeah. I know you don't want to become predictably unpredictable. You've got to make it a guessing game to an extent, but it isn't coming quick enough. And we're talking here constructively because we see the potential in Miwa Hatamoto. 15 years of age. Remarkable talent.
Yeah, absolutely right.
But Sun a class above.
Hanamoto has twice beaten the world number 8. That's a best ever victory. Shin Yubin and Kasumi Ishikawa. It's a big ask to go and beat a world number 1.
Let 4-9.
Six championship points in terms of this match. Still a long way to go to match points. There we go. She reigns supreme once again.